The story took up but half the front page, allowing for the possibility that some readers might be more interested in the failing arms talks between China and Japan, the conclave of cardinals electing a new pope in Rome, or the latest news on Arbuckle's retrial in San Francisco. The jury deadlocked again. Even so, the main picture was of Mabel Normand, looking rapt and alluring in a studio publicity shot, swathed in off-the-shoulder furs and an enormous velvet hat, her glamour undercut by the melodramatic headline, linked in sinister drama of mystery, and a caption suggesting she had been questioned in connection with the murder. Tom drank in the detail. Beside the picture of Normand was one of Taylor, a quarter the size, and a graphic photo diagram reconstructing the murder, a crude sketch of the gunman and his flailing victim superimposed on a crisply focused photograph of Taylor's front room. The gist was how Times investigators had dug up four witnesses who saw a stranger behaving suspiciously near Taylor's home the evening of the murder. One even provided a detailed description of the man's clothing. All very convincing, but nobody could doubt that what most readers would remember was the photo of Miss Normand. He looked across the street at the fashionable residential block opposite, Alvarado Court. It was a 5-minute stroll from the modest frame house he rented, but it could have been a million miles away. 8 elegant duplexes grouped around a pretty courtyard garden open to the street. Wrought iron balconies added a slash of Spanish zest to the white walls and green tile roofs. A central flower bed eased the eye towards a vine-clad sun pavilion. Stillness enveloped everything. The place was built to exude peace, solidity, and discreet wealth. It did the job well. Not a sign remained of the outcry raised 24 hours before when Taylor's murdered body was found by his manservant arriving for work.